there. Thank you for joining me today for another Sean and Raza Cup challenge. This time we're doing Super Double Dragon. Wait, no. Return of Double Dragon. I think my work is cut out for me today. I am not an aficionado on this game. I'm no expert. And watching some of the other videos out there, one thing is apparent. This game's really, really tough. I tried to jump into it and play the way that I saw PJ Venom do in his attempt, and man, I got my ass kicked. All right, I mean, I don't think I got through the first bit of stage one. I had to figure some things out, right? So I came back. I gave it another try. I rethought things. And I think I put together what is quite possibly the most boring beat-em-up video that you're ever going to see. It's a high score challenge, people. And I set the bar pretty high on this one. Thank you for joining me today. I'm John. This is Retro Projections. Alright, well, here it is from Technos of Japan, Return of Double Dragon. Now, I don't own Super Double Dragon. I own this version, the Japanese release. Some people say it's easier. I cannot verify whether it is or isn't. But here are the rules. Normal difficulty, one life, high score wins. And then I just do this. Over and over. Until I kill the bad guys. Because I couldn't figure out a way to block. I couldn't figure out a way to land punches. Whatever I tried to do, I failed at. I'll show you. Here. I watched PJ Venom's video, and he was just duking it out with the guys, standing there, mano-y-mano, and punching them. So I attempted that, and they're too fast. There's no hit stun when you punch them, and they gang up, and unlike every other Double Dragon game, they don't wait their turn in this one. So I couldn't do that. I was just getting creamed. So I resorted to the only thing I could figure out, which is this special technique, and just spamming it. You know, it's in the game. Perhaps some people say that it's not very sporting to use this. The thing about this version versus Super Double Dragon, in Super Double Dragon, you hit them only once with the kick, but it takes less hits to defeat an enemy, and you also get more points. This version, you get less points, you can hit them a lot. I mean, there are some enemies you'll see me kick 20, 30 times before they die in this, but it was the only way I could survive. I don't know if it's level 6 or I think it is, where I end up falling in this run. You are forced to climb these stairs, and the hit detection in this game is so janky that enemies that were not on my plane would attack, and the game, by that point in time, it was fuming. I swear there was smoke coming out of it, because it was so pissed at me. It would move my character sprite over to the left or to the right so that I would get hit by an attack that would have missed me otherwise. So it's a cheap game. I still think that I got the best of it, and it was just throwing a little temper tantrum. But you can judge for yourself if you would like. You can watch the whole dang video. Of course, I don't think you will want to. One, because if you like beat-em-ups, this one isn't a great one. And if you like this one, then you probably can't stand watching me just do the same thing over and over and over. But that's what you're gonna get. Well, I hope you enjoy this video. I'm gonna shut up now and let you watch for 49 minutes. Oh my God.
Thank you.